right, Jason, are you there? Are you seeing anything on video-wise right now? Because I don't have anything.
I'm not seeing anything, Joe. Not seeing anything at all.
There we go. Welcome in to Storm Surge, live from Daytona Beach, Florida. I apologize for all of the technical issues that we are having at the moment, as a little bit of a technology snafu is what I should call it, as we are getting going tonight here on Storm Surge. But our main event is the fact that the hurricane, actually it's not even a hurricane, it's the Smokey, will be taking on the Lone Wolf coming up as our championship match, as that will be getting going. Smokey has won himself a title opportunity by going through four different men as we spoke throughout this week. And Jason, this looks like it is going to be an amazing match.
Well, Smokey has really climbed the ladder as far as River Region Wrestling as part of the new blood. And the technical difficulties be damned and everything like that. It could be a storm surge that's knocking out the internet. I don't know what's going on, but the one thing's for sure tonight, Joe, the forecast is going to call for pain, and one side's going to be triumphant and the other one's going to be very disappointed.
It absolutely is. And as we speak right now, we are finding out that our technical issues are continuing and we are unable right now. We are stuck in the screen. Jason, we are stuck right here. We cannot move forward. Nothing is playing right. Nothing is happening as we are trying to get going with Storm Surge tonight from KC or from Daytona Beach, Florida.
Well, the meteorologist must have lied about the forecast, because something's going on here. I don't know what's going on with the bus. I know they're scrambling around, but your guess is as good as mine, Joe. I don't know what the heck is going on.
I don't know either. We originally were unable to get going tonight because of the technical issues that were not allowing our video feed to even be shown. And here we are now, just 5 minutes into this, and our streams are going dark, coming back up, going dark again. Jason, I don't know what we are doing right now.
I was going to say, did River Region Wrestling get bought out by a corporate radio company? Because, I mean, we've never had these problems before.
No, we absolutely have not. We have never had these issues before. And as we are talking right now, I'm being told that we are trying to patch the feed back in as we go along. So if you see some weird things on your video screen, that is us. Don't worry. Your thing is no. Look at this. We're restarting the whole thing. Let's see if this is going to work this time, Jason. No, still no screen. No screen, Jason.
What the hell is going on here? Somebody get the engineer now.
We can't even hear you. Are you there, Jason? Are you there?
I'm right here.
We've got the pyros.
As we're speaking.
At least the pyros have went off two times. As we're going to start this over again, we apologize to everybody in the amphitheater tonight from Daytona Beach as Storm Surge is getting going for a second time. And here we go. Coming up, it is the Lone Wolf and Smokey, as the Lone Wolf will be defending his championship against that new blood that Jason was speaking to as our computer systems and our televisions went out momentarily. And I think we are going now, Jason, coming up here as well. As you see it, it will be the tag team championships that will be on the line as the Lone Wolf and McCracken and the Reapers will get going. But Jason, coming up here in just a few seconds to kick off Storm Surge tonight, we will have the United States Championship. Fletch, who last defended this title. Actually, Jason, he's never defended this title. He defeated Sam Hain at the beginning, and now he is going to have to defend it against that monster. Let's go down to ringside.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. fighting is for the United States Championship.
The monster known as Sam Hain. He was the United States champion up until Semper Fight Night, when the entire clan of Reapers attacked him in the ring and allowed Fletch to get the pin. And Jason, as we started season two of River Region Wrestling, this man defeated seven other River Region wrestlers to become the number one contender and take on the leader of the Reapers here in just a few seconds as we start getting Storm Surge going from Daytona Beach.
And begrudgingly, I'll say he got a nice little tune-up last week against Dr. Dewey Cheatham, where this man has been absolutely unstoppable. But tonight, Fletch, who's been trying to be Hollywood Hulk Hogan and not defend his title, the day of reckoning is coming tonight, and the hurricane, the storm surge, whatever you want to call it, it is the storm surge pay-per-view. It may be coming for Fletch and the Creepers tonight.
And Sam Hain has had to deal with the Reapers, we'll say shenanigans, for the past few weeks, as he at one point in time was actually teamed up with Yorkie to go up against the tag team champions. We were wondering what Yorkie's strategy was, but Jason, it was all a setup to set it up. In the moment that the match was over, the Reapers attacked the ring and attacked Sam Hain and made it where he couldn't even walk out. And now, here comes the champ.
And the one thing too is, Sam Hain, you can't beat this guy with brute force, so maybe you've got to play a little psychology. Maybe that's the strategy for the Reapers. I'm just guessing from that standpoint, but any little edge can work for Fletch tonight because he's going to need it.
He is the leader of the Reapers, and he is coming to the ring alone, which is the one thing that Sam Hain has not done. And that is lose to a competitor one-on-one in the ring. The loss to Fletch was after an attack in a no DQ match. And then the only other loss that he had was with the Reapers and with Yorkie in that challenge, that open challenge match that happened a couple of weeks ago. And we all saw that that was the setup that we just mentioned a few moments ago. Is Fletch going to be able to do what nobody else in River Region Wrestling has been able to do so far, and that is defeat the monster known as Sam Hain?
Yes, and if I'm a betting man, I'm going to say no, because he had to get some help the last time, and I wouldn't be surprised if we saw it again tonight from the Reapers, who are trying to gain back a little bit of momentum that they kind of lost in the last couple of weeks.
Right now, you've got our chat open to you on our Facebook feed here for Kansas City PA, KCPN. Make sure that you follow KCPN no matter where you are on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, as well as Facebook and Instagram. Let's go down to the ring.
From the wasteland, weighing in at 273 pounds. And introducing the champion, from Montgomery, Alabama, weighing in at 265 pounds. He is the Reaper.
Fletch, the second Triple Crown winner
in River Region Wrestling history. After picking up that championship against Sam Hain, he has won the heavyweight championship. He has been a tag team champion. Now let's see if he can defend the United States Championship against Sam Hain. Let's get Storm Surge going. After a bumpy start, we're going now, Jason.
Here we go, and one thing for sure, Fletch, I hope he has his America boots tonight because he's going to need them.
Sam Hain, not only 6'10", 275 pounds, but athletic. Look at the athleticism from the monster known as Sam Hain.
And already Fletch is seeing stars.
This could be interesting. I find it to be ballsy. In fact, almost egotistical that Fletch came out here. Oh, nice boot to the face. Almost egotistical to come out here without the rest of the Reapers. This is going to be interesting.
But I wouldn't put it past you, Joe, that they may be hanging out in the back. You might see them creep in a little bit to maybe give Fletch an edge. Don't be surprised.
This is the first of two matches that Fletch has tonight, as he is going to be taking on the Lone Wolf and McCracken for the tag team titles coming up here in just a few minutes. Heck, he may even be staying in the ring depending on what happens here, because that match is scheduled to be next. And right now, he's on the offensive to Sam Hain. Look at the height difference. And Fletch is not a short man, and he is being able to hang around right now with Sam Hain. It's unusual to see somebody be able to do this against the monster. Nice athleticism again.
Just unreal, the athleticism, agility. But right there, he was a little too slow there. Fletch able to get the edge.
You've seen it so far. Fletch has been able to counter Sam Hain. He's seen him a couple of times. He's also probably wrestled Sam Hain more than anybody in River Region Wrestling over the course of the last few months. And we will see if that is actually what's going to help benefit Fletch through the remainder of this match.
Yeah, nice, just looking now, though. But you cannot let up on this Sam Hain fella, because he's just going to make you pay for it time and time again.
He is, and as a matter of fact, has our feed gone out again? Is our feed happening? Is this going on one more time? What on earth is happening tonight?
Where's the truck? What are you guys doing back there?
Why on earth is this going on? What is happening? We are in the middle of a match, and it is messing up again. What is happening? Are we even on anymore? What is going on?
I better be careful with what I say on a hot mic just in case. But right now, it looks like we're just dead to the world right now. We're just staring at a frozen screen of Sam Hain standing over Fletch as he's struggling to get back to his feet.
He absolutely is. We have no clue what's going on right now ourselves. Let's see. Oh, there's – okay, so the intro is going back again. Let's see if we can send it back down to the ring. There's our music. Jason, are you hearing that?
I'm hearing it. Well, I was.
You were.
I'm hearing something.
All right. Are we back in? Okay, we are back in. Jason, are you seeing this? Are you seeing the fact that Fletch now has a little bit of a lead on Sam Hain?
Yep, a little twist and turn coming from the matchup right now for the United States Championship. Fletch, he needs to stay on him and capitalize in this matchup.
Sam Hain, now look at the clothesline. Great offensive maneuver. As this is going on, apparently what is happening on the screen was not affecting the match in Daytona Beach right now. So we apologize for all of our viewers that were seeing the mess ups as we continue here from this. But look at the submission maneuver. Can he make Sam Hain tap? Think about trying to make this monster tap and Sam Hain gets out of it.
Nope, too much strength from Sam Hain on that one. You're not going to be able to get him that easy.
All right, nice fireman carry by the champ on that. Sam Hain getting the boot to the face. And again, Fletch putting up more offense than almost anybody. You saw this just a couple of weeks ago with Dr. Dewey, and we saw this as Sam Hain beat him last week in the open challenge. So far, maybe Fletch has been able to scout all these matches that Sam Hain has had over the course of the past few weeks.
Yeah, but he decided to showboat right there, and it's now making him pay again, Sam Hain. You cannot waste any time when you're facing up against a monstrous freak like this guy.
Oh, here we go. Sam Hain now looking to try to finish it. Is he going to? Oh, it's reversed.
Spear
is reversed. But Sam Hain back on the offensive, and look at the send time. Right there, moonsault once again as he gets in that offensive maneuver on Fletch. And here we go, right forearm, another right forearm. Boom, boom to the face. Enziguri, great move by the monster.
You ever seen a 7-foot Pele? There you go.
And Sam Hain sending him back up. Spear! There it is! Is this it? Is Sam Hain 3 seconds away from becoming champ?
You had the pennant right there. You had it.
And he doesn't do so. And instead, once again, kicks to the back of the forehead and Fletch is down.
And another clothesline right there again. Fletch is on his heels right now. He's a coffin on roller skates. He better come up with something quick.
Sam Hain now with the right boots. Now maybe taking too much time to celebrate. He's got Fletch where he wants him. He can become the United States champion again, but instead he's celebrating and Fletch is back on his feet.
Yeah, very off-brand for Sam Hain.
Nice, though, that didn't cost him. Nice move. And Sam Hain looking and staring down at the leader of the Reapers.
Yeah, Fletch just took a knee harder than Nancy Kerrigan did back in the 90s.
Right hands by Sam Hain. Fletch rolls to the outside. Is Fletch calling to get quits? Is he saying screw this? Is he done? Referee starting to count. Fletch saying goodbye. He's going back to the ring. No, there's Yorkie. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Yorkie. Yorkie just now hitting him. Oh, Yorkie just turned on Fletch.
Wow. Oh, did not see that coming.
The leader of the Reapers had just been double-crossed by his vice president. And is it enough? Fletch is back on the outside. Yorkie back in the back. These two were supposed to have a tag team title shot here in just a few minutes. And now Fletch is having to rebound and Sam Hain is in control.
Well, nobody saw this storm coming. Even though this pay-per-view is called Storm Surge, nobody saw that coming.
And spear by Sam Hain. Is it time?
That's it.
Fletch wobbling, getting to his feet. The monster setting him up. And it is time to go.
Good to night.
Sleep.
Good night.
One. Two, three, Sam Hain wins the United States Championship.
And in the famous words of Ludacris, go to sleep, Garden Tool. You are out for the count.
And the former now Reaper, I'm guessing former Reaper, or is Fletch out of this? Wait a second. Who is out? Did Yorkie just take over the Reapers?
It's going to be interesting to see the outcome of this developing situation as Yorkie surprising everyone tonight at Daytona Beach, Florida with the betrayal, the Judas effect, pun intended, on one Fletch. It's going to be interesting what this does for the Reapers going forward.
And Sam Hain is your new United States champion. And I don't even know if this match, okay, we're getting word. This match has been pushed back, Jason, okay? The crew in the back has said that the tag team titles will now be on the line for the main event. And now it is going to be time for our River Region Wrestling Championship.
One fall. It is for the Deep South Heavyweight Championship.
Can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long
He is one of the newest River Region wrestlers, conquering two other veterans of the Triple R, defeating Yorkie in the championship after beating McCracken in his opening round semifinal match. And now, the new guy, Smokey, the former ICP member, is making his way to the ring and could make history if he can defeat the Lone Wolf here at Storm Surge in just a few minutes.
And it looks like he's got the Tony the Tiger get up because he expects to be great tonight.
There is no Sub-Zero and no ice in his veins tonight. As the orange one, the blue meanie, is not coming to the ring, Smokey means business. And for him to become the River Region Wrestling Champion and to scale the mountain, he will have to defeat this man.
So if these matchups were on a Sunday, would he wear the red like Tiger Woods? I need to know this answer.
I'll let you ask him.
Backstage interview coming soon.
River Region Wrestling Champion, the Alpha, the Lone Wolf, makes his way to the ring. He knew he was wrestling next. He just thought that this was going to be a tag team opportunity. He, like the rest of us, just found out that the tag team title match has been moved to the main event because we need to figure out who will be Yorkie's tag team partner in this after what just happened at Storm Surge. And now the Lone Wolf has to take on Smokey. You saw the image just a few seconds ago. If you would like this shirt, you can get it by simply going to River or going to Territory Wrestling Tees and putting in the passcode RRR, and you will get 10% off at the purchase of whatever items that you want from Territory Wrestling Tees, including the Lone Wolf's t-shirt that he is wearing to the ring right now. But now, it is time to see if the newest River Region wrestler can defeat the reigning champion. Let's send it to the ring.
Introducing the challenger from New York, weighing in at 267 pounds, Smokey. And introducing the champion from Huntsville, Alabama, weighing in at 225 pounds, he is the Alpha.
The Alpha of River Region Wrestling, the Lone Wolf, handing his championship over to our River Region Wrestling referee. Will that be the last time he holds this championship? Let's see. It is time for the River Region Wrestling Championship here at Storm Surge in Daytona Beach. There's the bell.
And here we go.
Smokey's already getting out of the ring.
A little bit of strategy, maybe a little bit of mind games from Smokey to start out. You know, we're in Daytona Beach, Florida, Joe, where this is setting up almost like Tom Brady versus Patrick Mahomes in the Super Bowl. We're just hoping maybe it's not as a lopsided outcome.
Trying to see. I was wondering. Oh, nice kick! Oh. offense already started by the Lone Wolf, and he doesn't care that Smokey's on the outside. The Lone Wolf is on the railing, and he just threw Smokey, or Smokey just now threw him. And here we go on the outside. Referee is counting.
He's getting intense already here on the outside. Look at that counter.
Nice backbreaker. Lone Wolf on his back. And maybe this was a good thing. Smokey trying to lure him out onto the mat, but now the Lone Wolf's back on the offensive, and he gets back into the ring, trying to get Smokey to come in, and here we go. Right hands by the challenger.
Look at that, but nice counter there by the Lone Wolf coming in, but Smokey coming back, just back and forth in this one. Well, this was already getting off to a hot and heavy start.
Nice suplex. Belly-to-back suplex, Smokey on the champ. The Lone Wolf not expecting to take Smokey on this early. Now an underhook suplex. I know we used to do this with Yorkie. Should we start doing a suplex count for Smokey on this? Because right now we're already up to two, and we're only 30 seconds into the ring, and Smokey's going to the second ring. Let's see what he's doing from that second turnbuckle. He's getting the Lone Wolf standing up. What is Smokey going to be doing? A little bit.
Oh, he waited. Waited too long on that one. And that's what you can't do with the experience of the Lone Wolf, is you can't give that man a chance to recuperate. Right now, Smokey's learning that the hard way.
Look at the strength of the Lone Wolf, picking it up and slamming Smokey on that. Smokey, a little bit bigger. Not trying to say he's fat, just saying he's a little bit bigger. He's got some thick thighs, man. But the Lone Wolf able to pick him up with ease.
You saying a little chunk in the trunk, maybe? Look at that right there.
Do not talk about the love handles. Nice, another suplex by Smokey. And now Lone Wolf getting pimp slapped in the turnbuckles as he's in the corner.
But again, Smokey's letting him recuperate. You can't do that.
Smokey needing to stay on the offensive here, not letting the Lone Wolf get up, and instead he's letting him get up, but he's still staying on the offensive, doing a very good job for this to be his first match against the Lone Wolf.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what you got to do against a veteran like the Lone Wolf. There's a reason he's holding the championship belt, and Smokey right now, who's just skyrocketing up the ladder here at River Region Wrestling with a big opportunity tonight here at Storm Surge.
Jason, getting some news from the back right now. We are being told that the tag team titles will be up for grabs regardless if Yorkie can find a tag team partner or not. This could be a handicap match, which may be good for the Lone Wolf if it is coming up here in our main event, because then the Lone Wolf may have a little bit of an advantage being able to hand it off to McCracken while he tries to recover from this match. Lone Wolf going and swinging and missing now on the outside.
Oh, my goodness.
We appreciate everybody from Israel being here tonight as far as our Israeli announce team out there on the outside. We appreciate it. The Lone Wolf doesn't appreciate it as much as we do, but we thank those guys for being here.
Yeah, and did you hear that thud? You can hear that thud all the way to Pensacola.
Once again, this going to the outside. Our referee counting at five. Is this the count? No. Okay. Smokey gets back in. And now Smokey getting back out to break out the count. Now the ref's got to start back at one.
Well, they say that iron's good for your diet. I don't think they're talking about that kind of iron that the Lone Wolf just got.
Smokey with some smart maneuvers right now. Lone Wolf laying on the ground. Smokey staying on the offensive, but also being very aware of our referee, making sure to get back in just like he's doing right now to kill that count so he can continue the offense on the outside.
Yeah, it seems that the offensive assault to the outside is working in the benefit of Smokey right now, and he wants to try to capitalize. The Lone Wolf coming there with the counter, hoping to get a second wind here.
The Lone Wolf just got pimp slapped by the Smoke. Oh,
look at that,
nice around the world DDT.
A much needed counter by the Lone Wolf. He was seeing stars there for a second, and now he's on the offensive.
He breaks up the count again, and we are continuing on the outside here at Storm Surge from Daytona Beach. Our very first match and event to happen outdoors, and we appreciate you joining us here on KCPN. Don't forget, coming up here in just a little bit, Triple B's is going to be going on KCPN. That kicks off at 8 o'clock. Fantastic full Nelson suplex by the champ.
Oh, man.
Lone Wolf again, breaking up the count himself. They don't care anything about being in the ring.
Nope. But in order to win the match, you've got to get the pinfall in the ring if you're Smokey, if you're going to come away with the gold tonight. And right now, the Lone Wolf just throwing an offensive arsenal at him.
Right now, this is benefiting another full Nelson suplex. Ref is at 5. And this is benefiting the Lone Wolf more than it is Smokey, because right now the Lone Wolf can retain his title if there is a count out, but he's got Smokey back in.
Right now, getting him on the offensive side. And one thing, too, Smokey, after that slew of arsenal on the outside, I know a guy who can help with the neck.
I think you're referring to Dr. Dewey Cheatham, who was not invited to the event tonight here at Storm Surge in Daytona Beach. Nice snap suplex by the Lone Wolf. Oh, is this going to be it? Is he going to wrap it up? Here it is. RTA lands it. Lands the RTA. Is it enough to put Smokey away? There's the cover. One. Oh, only a one count.
Wow.
Only a one count.
The last gasp for Smokey, because right now, he's about to be on the receiving end. Lone Wolf looking to finish this off right now.
Belly to belly suplex by the champ. Look at that. Underarm. It was almost an angle slam by the Lone Wolf right now, getting those maneuvers and now throwing Smokey into the turnbuckle. Oh, nice bulldog from the top rope. And Smokey rolls out.
Very smart of Smokey to get out of the ring. Momentum was getting away from him. Take a deep breath, get back in, regroup. There's still a lot of match left.
There is, and there is another match for the Lone Wolf tonight, as he still has to defend the tag team titles against Yorkie, potentially in a handicap match. And now Smokey getting the Lone Wolf up on it. Look at that slam by Smokey, baiting the Lone Wolf. And now the Lone Wolf's got to be careful.
Stay on it, Smokey.
Is this it? Is this enough? Is he going to put the champ away? Do we have another? No, reversal by the Lone Wolf.
He took too much time. Took too much time. He had him.
He had him. And around the world, DDT again by the champ. He's setting it up. He's looking. He's backing away. Is it enough? Here we go. RTA. RTA. Smokey is down. Here's the pin. 1, 2, 3. Lone Wolf retains.
Gutsy effort by the Lone Wolf, but kudos to Smokey for this showing tonight. But he's learned some valuable lessons. The alpha male, you cannot give him any room whatsoever, or he's going to make you pay with an RTA.
And the alpha retains his championship, and he is still the River Region Wrestling Champion. But the question is going to be, coming up in a few minutes, is he going to be the tag team champion of River Region Wrestling? We are going to be finding out momentarily, as that is the question. Who is Yorkie going to get?
Are we live? Finally. Because I have shit to do. Let's make this quick. Good evening. I am the president of Extreme Alternative, Extreme Virtual Pro Wrestling. They always say, in order to make noise, you have to be the loudest one in the room. Well, here we are. River Region Wrestling, watch your back, because we're taking over.
And I don't know if he can do that here in the next few minutes, if Yorkie's been able to find a tag team partner, or if he is going to go with somebody inside of the Reapers. Is it Fletch that is out of the Reapers? We have no clue about what is going on, but the Lone Wolf is staying in the ring, and now it is time for him to defend his tag team championship with McCracken.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see who Yorkie picks. Will he burn the bridge with Sam Hain after the little setup from last week? So if I'm a betting man, Sam Hain's probably out of the picture from that standpoint. But it could be anybody. It could even be, for some reason, Dr. Dewey Cheatham. We don't know.
He could go with the doctor. I don't know why he would go with the doctor, but he could go with the doctor.
You need a jerk to win, and he's the best one.
And again, he still has two other members of the Reapers, if he so chooses. Is it DJ Donnie? Is it Honcho? Or is it one of those two? Is he going to go? It could be Linden, who we haven't seen since the return. It could be her. It could be Bulldozer. There are so many options for Yorkie. But if he has not found a tag team partner by now, this will be a handicap match with the champs looking to retain once again and move on as your River Region Wrestling Tag Team Champion. As McCracken makes his way to the ring, you have to think that a lot of this is going to be on McCracken after the battle that the Lone Wolf just went through a few moments ago to defend his River Region Wrestling Championship. McCracken's going to be the most fresh guy in this ring, depending on how healthy the Lone Wolf is after that match with Smokey, because Smokey took him to the limit. Is it going to be enough? Did he just help Yorkie out to potentially pull the upset? Jason, it is time. Let's see who Yorkie has chosen. Monster, your brand new United States champion, Sam Hain. And now it looks like Yorkie has left the Reapers and is now a disciple, as he has teamed up with the Monster to take on the River Region Wrestling Tag Team Champions.
Thank God we're not on network television, Joe, because I can say this, shit just got real.
It absolutely did. As Yorkie has himself a new look, a new tag team partner, and in just a few minutes will he have himself yet another title, as he would be a two-time tag team champion. He has left the Reapers in his reasoning to do so after trying for days and months to regain those tag team titles. And now he is going to try to do so with the monster known as Sam Hain. Let's head down to the ring. Apparently technical issues again. It's not our first one tonight. Our video streams have went out. Our opens have played when they weren't supposed to. One open didn't even play at the very beginning. And now here we are, our microphone down for our in-ring announcer. Danny can't even get that off. This is now an Extreme Rules Tornado Tag Match. And we will see If Yorki and Sam Hain can win the tag team titles against McCracken and the Lone Wolf.
And the pressure right now is on the tag team champions after Lone Wolf has already been through a battle with Smokey and Sam Hain, my God.
What a move. So far, the Lone Wolf hasn't even taken his shirt off. He got his shirt on. Oh, look at the athleticism, but he misses.
Oh! The Disciples are here to make a message tonight.
Yorki and McCracken, the two freshest men, are in the ring. Sam Hain and the Lone Wolf, who have already wrestled tonight, going at it. And the Lone Wolf trying to get the chair involved, unsuccessful, and just got body slammed.
Well, remember what I said? It was about to pick up. We're already there, just 2 minutes into this matchup.
And the baseball bat coming out now. Reversal. Sam Hain. Oh, and oh no, reversal again. Lone Wolf getting it. Sam Hain gets the bat this time.
It's kind of a game of tug of war right now.
A tug of war over the bat, and the Lone Wolf swings and misses. There it is.
That's one way to take him down.
Sam Hain is down. The Lone Wolf picking up the chair. Yorki in the ring with McCracken.
Right on the back.
The Lone Wolf trying to keep Sam Hain down.
Oh, nice comeback.
The United States champion, the River Region Wrestling champion, going at it on the outside as Yorki and McCracken going at it on the inside. Yorki has been dominating McCracken so far, but now back in that ring, McCracken's been able to get some offensive maneuvers in, and now the Lone Wolf is trying to get in to help McCracken. Nope, never mind.
Well, we thought he was, but he's taking a second look at Sam Hain. Maybe not.
Swing and a miss. Oh, nice move by Sam Hain.
What in the blue hell just happened?
450 splash from over the rope. And now McCracken and Sam Hain on the outside as the Lone Wolf and Yorki go at it in the ring. And McCracken's back in to help the Lone Wolf. Sam Hain needs to get back in to help Yorki out. Sam Hain going back to the top turnbuckle. Another high-risk maneuver by him. Oh, misses it again.
Well, they're doing
missed
a good job right
Wolf.
Now. They're doing a good job right now of neutralizing Sam Hain and putting the pressure on Yorki right now. If this match goes further and they stay the course, their chances of winning are going to go up.
Lone Wolf, belly to back suplex onto the mat, to the face. And Sam Hain now in the ring, boot to McCracken. And the Lone Wolf is getting beat down by Yorki. Look at the athleticism by Sam Hain once again. Remember, first pinfall wins. First submission wins. This is not an elimination. The first pinfall or submission will win this Extreme Rules match. And the tag team titles are on the line.
And I like
right
how
hand
McCracken,
to the Lone Wolf.
And I like how McCracken and the Lone Wolf have switched up now. McCracken a little bit more fresh, now coming in to maybe bring down Sam Hain a little bit and soften him up.
But remember, the only way that you can win this is inside the ring. So right now, Yorki is just beating the Lone Wolf down. And it's actually Sam Hain and McCracken that can finish this match in the ring. Will it happen? Sam Hain picking McCracken up.
Uh-oh.
Is it going to sleep? Is he going to sleep?
Good
knee
night.
To the face. Here we go. Lone Wolf cannot help. One, two, three. The Disciples have won the River Region Wrestling Championship, and they are the brand new tag team champions of the world.
A new team who sent a very, very stern message tonight, and they come away with gold. Yorki, once again, picking probably the best of River Region Wrestling, Sam Hain. The Disciples, you're going to hear about them for a good time, as it seems right now.
And Yorki cannot believe it. What will this mean for the Reapers, for the Disciples. Stay tuned as Tuesday Night Throwdown coming up in 2 weeks. What will happen in the fallout from Storm Surge? We appreciate you joining us from Daytona Beach. We will see you next Tuesday.